Yes, lads, welcome back to another custom tactics video on the channel. Today we're taking a look at my top four formations and custom tactics in FIFA 23. Let's go. Does your team look like this? Do you struggle to complete those game-changing SBCs and play with the best players in FIFA 23? If you said yes to any of this, then you need to get over to AYYLP and secure yourself some cheap and reliable foot coins and use code AYYLP at checkout for an extra 3% off. Jeez. So before we dive in, just a quick one. If you've not already, subscribe to the channel and drop a like if you found this useful. It really does help the channel grow, and I appreciate all the love you guys have shown over the last couple of months, weeks, however long you've been around. It's been amazing. However, this is my personal preference on the top four tactics in the game. I've used it to get like elite and rank ones and so on. So this is what I'm going to be going into ultimate tots with. And stick around to the end of the video because we are going to be opening our compensation. We finally received it. We finally got it. Let's go. Anyways, first formation on the list, number one, my favorite, in my opinion, is the 4-3-2-1. What a formation. Honestly, it's just so reliable. It does everything you need to do. Defends in that 4-4-2, which we like. And it just, the way it moves going forward is just different. So we do 40 on the width, 70 on the depth, balance and direct passing, 50 on the width, players in the box 6, 1 and 1 on corners and free kicks, just so you're limiting those counter attacks. Instructions: stay central, getting behind on the striker, stay central, getting behind on the left center forward, and then come back on defense, getting behind on the right center forward. Depending on which guy you want to have come back, it will affect how you set up your midfield. So because I've got Sanchez coming back, so he'll defend in front of Klaus. You've got Zidane, stay back while attacking and cover center, and Barella, stay back while attacking and cover center. And then Sanchez is then on cover wing. So as you can see, Sanchez drops in front of Klaus, Zidane and Barella hold the middle of the field, and then Sanchez pushes out left, and it creates your first bank of four. Four backs then. We have the right fullback on stay back while attacking and overlap, and then the left fullback on balance and overlap. It doesn't matter which fullback you have overlap, just make sure you have one because it will stretch the play for you, and this formation can be a bit narrow. And then goalkeeper, it's Edison, comes for crosses, and sweeper keeper. That will be the same on all the tactics, and this is my favorite formation in the game. However, sometimes your favorite formation doesn't quite care for you. So I've got these other three bad boy formations. This formation here, the 4-3-1-2, the video came out yesterday. So the tactics are on your screen now, how you set it up. Take a screenshot, take your time. 35 on the width, 60 on the depth. Balance direct passing, 50 on the offensive width. Players in the box on 6-1-1 on corners and free kicks. Amazing formation. This slot I often rotate. So sometimes this will be like a 4-3-3-4. 4-3-3-5, 4-1-2-1-2. But I think overall this has been my favorite. I call this more like my wild card formation. I don't use it all the time, but it is a nice alternative to using the 4-3-2-1 and then the 3 and 5 backs. Instructions: you would have seen in yesterday's video, stay central, getting behind on the strikers, come back on defense, get into the box on the cam. And then it doesn't matter which one you've got. Stay back while attacking, cover center. Stay back while attacking, cover center on these two center mids. And then Zidane, cover wide, get into the box crosses. So it's going to be a more attacking orientated midfielder. If you want to see, obviously, more in depth on these tactics as well as how they play in game, just find the video on the channel. All these tactics have a video on the channel where you'll be able to see where I break down what players you need in each position and so on. But yeah, if you want your so Sanchez will defend on the right hand side. Again, this will defend in a 4-4-2. Sanchez will go on the right hand side because these two are cover center, so they'll cover in front of the center backs, and Zidane when defending will go out left. If you want this guy, the right center mid, to cover wing, that's fine. Just make sure these two are on cover center. Then Sanchez will naturally drop into that left mid position. This cam will just go wherever the free space is, as long as you've got the midfield set up this way. Centre backs, obviously, don't touch them. I'll find you. I'm not going to say that for every single tactic. Goalkeeper comes for crosses and sweeper keeper. Fullback is stay back while attacking and overlap. And then another formation where we have one of our fullbacks overlap on the attack. So it creates the width. Again, quite a narrow formation. So you do need the fullbacks to get forward. If you want to send both fullbacks forward, remember you could always up and left on the D-pad. That'll send them forward on their own. But then if you go up and right as well, they'll hug the touch lines, which is amazing. So that is second formation. Now we're into some sweaty tactics. Now, I'll always start in a 4-3-2-1. Depending on how my opponent sets up, I will choose one of these formations. If they're using any other three back or a five back that isn't the 5-4-1, I will use this formation. If they're using a 5-4-1, I will match them because I want to be ensuring the numbers on the fullbacks marry up as well as the midfield, because it is tough to stop the 4-5-4-1. I think the best counter to the 5-4-1 is sadly to play it. Because of how many bodies it gets forward and back, you've got to match it. The 3-4-2-1 is still very good against the 5-4-1, though. If you're better than the player, you will beat them. But if they're a good skill level, matching it, you can never go wrong. If you're struggling against an opponent, don't be afraid to match their formation, because I do that often. I'll just go into the menus, have a look what they're using, and then switch it up and use my own tactics, but in the same formation they are, just so it matches up. So basically, whoever's better at the game should win, really. But anyways, 3-4-2-1, 35 on the width, 70 on the depth, balanced and direct passing, 50 on the attacking width, players in the box on 6, 1-on-1 for corners and free kicks, 1-on-1 always on all my tactics, as you can see, just to prevent those counterattacks, ultimately. So, striker, stay central, get in behind, as always. The two center forwards stay central, getting behind, so they're always going to be there. I don't have them come back. It's just that's a bit too sway. If you do that, shame on you. Anyway, the left mid and right mid both come back on defense. Recommend that you choose players that can attack and defend in this area. They're going to get a lot of opportunities to pass the byline, so a good passing stat is important. But yeah, come back on defense, stay wide on both of them, and that is all. Basically, he's going to play in a five back. You'll tell your friends you play a three back. Well, we know you play a five back. We all know. Two center mid, stay back while attacking and cover center. That's fine. Center backs, touch them and I'll find you. Standard procedure. Goalkeeper comes across his sweeper keeper. This, in my opinion, is one of the most fun formations in terms of just like creating the width. So effective going forward. The only problem that I would say with it is when they overload the midfield, the left mid and right mid, because they don't come back on defense, they kind of slot in beside the center backs. And that causes you to be mismatched sometimes in midfield when they've got like four in midfield. So if they're playing a 4-4-2, that's a good formation to counter this, I think. As well as like a 4-3-2-1. They've always got that extra body in midfield, which they can use if they're smart to just overload you, because they'll always have a free man. But for the most part, most people don't read that, and you are sound in this formation for the most part. Super killer formation. Probably the second formation I go into if the 4-3-2-1 isn't working. And then ultimately, this is an emergency formation. Sometimes you've just got to do 5-4-1. Sometimes you've just got to do it. If you want to survive and you want to clutch out those big wins then and hit those big ranks, sometimes you just got to do it, lads. Sometimes you just got to do it. Balanced, 35 on the defensive width, 65 on the defensive depth. Remember, all the depths, you need to just play with them and see what you're most comfortable with. Balanced and direct passing. Don't be afraid to knock this down to like 60, 55, so on. You know what I mean? Width, as always, 50, players in the box on 6, just helps those that left mid and right mid get involved with the play. I'll explain how it works in a second. 1-on-1 on the corners and free kicks, which is, you know, important. So striker, stay central, get in behind, very, very clutch. You need to have someone quite fast in this formation because he's on his own sometimes, hardly ever, because the way it works. Two center mid, stay back while attacking and cover center, pretty standard. The left mid and right mid are the most important players in this formation. You want them to come back on defense, sweaty, I know, cut inside, get in behind, get into the box or across. Now, that's a lot of tactics on two players. Both are the same. Come back, cut inside, get in behind, get into the box or across. So what they do, when you're attacking, Mbappe on this picture looks like he's on his own, but he really isn't. So that's Sanchez and Jairzinho. So you need to make sure you have proper attackers here. You can't just have wing backs because you need them to be really good in front of goal, like Jairzinho or Sanchez. So they're going to come inside. So they're going to literally be, when you're attacking, next to Mbappe. And then what happens is when they vacate these left mid and right mid areas to be in the front line with Mbappe, Klaus and Nuno will join the attack and overlap. So the space left by Jairzinho and Sanchez, that's taken up by the fullbacks. So essentially, they go into the middle and then the fullbacks bomb up and you've got loads of width. That's why this formation is so effective, because then when you lose the ball, then it springs back into this four block in midfield, then five in defense. And that's why it's so hard to break down. Center backs, you don't touch them. I ain't even going to say it again. You just don't touch them. Center back, and then the goalkeeper comes for crosses and sweeper keeper. And that is my top four formations in FIFA 23, as well as the tactics. We do have now some compensation from League One Tots. So we're just going to rip it and see what we get. First one, we get Annihilated Cabela. And then the last one, come on, please give me a Medina. Not the best. Let me know what you got in the comments down below. And best of luck for this weekend, League. Jeez.